Greetings, everyone. The Department of Home Affairs has released a press statement issued on the 4th of July 2024. We'll read the statement as it is. I quote, "New Home Affairs Minister Dr. Leon Straper extends temporary visa concession to safeguard applicants from adverse consequences caused by processing delays. In his first official act as the new Minister of Home Affairs, just one day after being sworn in, Dr. Leon Straper has extended the temporary concession for foreign nationals who are currently awaiting the outcome of visa, waiver, and appeal applications. This extension safeguards applicants, including those who are contributing to South Africa through their scarce skills, from suffering adverse consequences or being erroneously declared undesirable while they await the outcome of applications submitted to the department. The processing of some of these applications has been delayed as the department works on reducing backlog. While the department has made progress in this regard since its previous communication on the matter, there is still a backlog in various visa and permit categories, and Minister Straper has now moved to protect applicants while the backlog is reduced. The decision to avert adverse consequences for applicants who seek to obtain lawful visa in order to contribute to South Africa, either through their skill or as tourists, signals the minister's commitment to improving the visa system to make South Africa a more attractive destination for international investment, tourism, and job creation. While it will take time to achieve this vision in full, the decision to extend the temporary concession serves as a signal of intent to reinvigorate the Department of Home Affairs and position it as a vital economic enabler. In order to build confidence in this new approach, Minister Straper further commits to avoiding a repeat of the current situation that has seen the previous concession expire prior to the extension being announced. While the department is committed to eradicating the backlog as soon as possible, the minister undertakes that any further extension, modification or amendment to the terms of these concessions will be communicated in writing prior to the new expiry date of 31st December 2024. The following temporary measures will apply with immediate effect. Applicants whose waiver application outcomes are still pending. Visa holders who have applied for a waiver and the waiver application is still pending as at 30 June 2024 are granted a further temporary extension until 31 December 2024 to enable the department to process the applications for applicants to collect their outcomes and to submit applications for appropriate visas. Those who wish to abandon their waiver applications and depart from South Africa will be allowed to exit at a port of entry before or on 31 December 2024 without being declared undesirable in terms of Section 30 bracket 1 bracket H of the Immigration Act 2002, read with Regulation 27 bracket 3 of the Immigration Regulations 2014. Visa holders who need to travel but are awaiting the outcome of waiver application will be allowed to exit and re-enter at a port of entry up to and including 31 December 2024 without being declared undesirable in terms of Section 31 bracket 1 bracket H of the Immigration Act 2002, read with Regulation 27 bracket 3 of the Immigration Regulation 2014. However, non-visa exempt applicants who travel out of the country with a waiver application receipt are required to apply for a port of entry visa which will allow them re-entry into South Africa. Applicants whose visa applications are still pending. Visa holders who have applied for long-term visas, that is visitors visa in terms of section 11 bracket 1 bracket B and 11 bracket 6 of the Immigration Act 2002, business visas, study visas, relatives visas and work visas, and whose application is still pending as at 30 June 2024, are granted a further temporary extension until 31 December 2024 of their current visa status. Applicants are not allowed to engage in any activity other than what the visa conditions provide for. Those who wish to abandon their visa applications will be allowed to exit at a port of entry before or on 31 December 2024 without being declared undesirable in terms of Section 30 bracket 1 bracket H of the Immigration Act 2002, read with Regulation 27 bracket 3 of the Immigration Regulations 2014. Visa holders who need to travel but are awaiting the outcome of a long-term visa application will be allowed to exit and re-enter at a port of entry up to and including 31 December 2024, read with the regulation, visa holders who need to travel but are awaiting the outcome of a long-term visa application will be allowed to exit and re-enter at a port of entry up to including 31 December 2024 without being declared undesirable in terms of Section 30 bracket 1 bracket H of the Immigration Act 2002, read with the Regulation 27 bracket 3 of the Immigration Regulations 2014. However, non-visa exempt applicants who travel out of the country with a long-term visa application receipt are required to apply for a port of entry visa which will allow them re-entry into South Africa. Applicants whose visa appeal applications are still pending. Visa holders who have applied, visa holders who have appealed a negative decision on an application for long-term visa, that is visitor's visa in terms of section 11 bracket 1 bracket B and 11 bracket 6 of the Immigration Act 2002, business visa, study visa, relative visas and work visas are granted a temporary extension until 31 December 2024 of the current visa status. Applicants are not allowed to engage in any activity other than what the visa conditions provide for. Those who wish to abandon their visa appeal applications and depart from South Africa will be allowed to exit at a port of entry before or on 31 December 2024 without being declared undesirable in terms of Section 30 bracket 1 bracket H of the Immigration Act 2002, read with Regulation 27 bracket 3 of the Immigration Regulations 2014. Those who wish to appeal applicants who need to travel but are awaiting the outcome of an appeal application for a long-term visa will be allowed to exit and re-enter at a port of entry up to and including 31 December 2024 without being declared undesirable in terms of Section 30 bracket 1 bracket H of the Immigration Act 2002, read with the Regulation 27 bracket 3 of the Immigration Regulations 2014. All appeal applicants are required to produce a copy of the rejection letter with a receipt for the appeal application on departure and re-entry into South Africa. Non-visa exempt appeal applicants who travel out of the country with an appeal application receipt are required to apply for a port of entry visa which will allow them to re-entry South Africa. Short-term visa holders issued in terms of Section 11, bracket 1, bracket A. Short-term visa holders issued in terms of Section 11, bracket 1, bracket A of the Immigration Act 2002 for 90 days or less who have applied for a renewal but have not received their visa renewal outcome must make the necessary arrangements to depart from South Africa within 90 calendar days from the date of expiry of the principal visa to avoid being declared undesirable. The letter concession is in line with the provisions of Section 11, bracket 1, bracket A of the Immigration Act 2002, which limits the duration of sojourn for visiting purposes to a total of 180 days. The temporary concession applies only to foreign nationals who have been legally admitted into South Africa. This concession is also only applicable to applicants who have submitted their applications via VFS Global and who can produce a variable receipt for such application against the VFS Global Tracking System. This statement was issued, as I said earlier, on the 4th of July 2024. I know that the Zimbabwe exemption holders will think that this speaks to them. In the previous videos, we did show you that when you go to the website of the Home Affairs, you will see a section that speaks to the Zimbabwe exemption permits, Lesotho exemption permits. So this statement issued does not speak to holders of Zimbabwe exemption permits, but it speaks to other foreigners who are in South Africa. Please like this video, subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you are on TikTok, please do follow us. Otherwise, goodbye.